Whether you say tomato or tomato, it's clear that your accent is a defining feature of who you are. Everyone has an accent. Heck, even goats have regional ways of saying baa. But what's the science behind language acquisition, and does your accent say something about you? In an American survey, 47% of adults found British accents to be sophisticated, while 51% thought New York accents were rude. Southern accents were considered nice, but possibly uneducated, while New England accents were considered intelligent. But it turns out that humans have a bias towards others who sound like them or who have the same accent. Of course, it's important to distinguish between a native language accent and an additional language accent. English native language accents depend on factors such as geographic location and socioeconomic status. For example, a Cockney accent of the working class London is markedly different than the Queen's received pronunciation. However, when it comes to non-native language accents, things are more complicated. If you decided to move to Spain and learn Spanish as an English speaker, you will always speak with an English accent, even if you remain there for decades. After the age of 12, the length of residence has almost no effect on your accent. Studies pinpoint the ideal age as 6 years old, with diminishing ability from that point forward. Interestingly, some stroke patients wake up with an accent completely different to their original voice. This condition is known as the foreign accent syndrome and results from damage to the insular region of the brain, which is responsible for language processing. One integral aspect of language is the phoneme. Phonemes are the different sound units we use to make up words, some of which are unique to different languages. For example, the phonemes with th, th, and th, as in words like the and thing, do not exist in German, making it difficult for German speakers to pronounce these words properly. Conversely, there are many phonemes in other languages that as English speakers we cannot pronounce or even hear properly. In a groundbreaking study, 32 American and 32 Japanese 6-month-old babies listened to a recording play la 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 repeatedly. When the recording switched to la la ra, a toy to the side would light up and play a musical tune. The babies were primed to understand that recognizing the difference between la and ra led to an audiovisual reward, and both the American and Japanese 6-month-old babies were able to tell the difference and anticipate the toy reward when necessary. But la and ra are phonemes that do not exist in the Japanese language. When the study was replicated with 10 to 12-month-old babies, the Japanese babies could not tell the difference between these uniquely English phonemes, showing that a critical period for recognizing phonemes and brain development is at merely 6 months old. If you try and learn a language, regardless of your age, synaptic connections are made, which ultimately create a denser gray matter and stronger white matter networks. In fact, those who have grown up in bilingual households are consistently more sensitive to subtle language differences compared to their monolingual counterparts. Brain scans have shown that bilingual babies have stronger brain responses in their orbital and prefrontal cortices, which are areas linked to focus and problem-solving abilities. But have you ever wondered why so many people hate the sound of their own voice? We break down the science and challenge some people to come to terms with their own voice in our new ASAP Thought video. Check it out with the link in the description. And subscribe for more weekly science videos.